It's Megan. So I'm recording another video. I just woke up like maybe 20 minutes ago, and I have a little bit of free time. So I was like, oh, let me quickly make a video, or let me just record, see if I can do this video. So this video is gonna be about dating and black guys and waiting for your dream black man. And that's the title of this video, and I want to talk about that because I've noticed that there are a couple of black women that say like they've given up on black guys, and black guys are trash and they're shitty and they're not good, and it's better to date other races of men because they can take care of you and they can provide for you better. And while I get that and I understand that, black guys, unlike other races of men, they don't really protect their women, they don't really protect us and all of that stuff. So, and I always hear like black women tell, other black women that, that waiting for your right, waiting until you meet a black man is wrong and it's wasting your time because, what if you're 50 and you're still single, and, you should just try interracial dating and give interracial dating a try because, the person for you might be, it might not be a black guy, it might be a Hispanic guy, it might be a white guy, it might be whatever. And while I get that, I understand that, I don't think there's anything wrong with interracial dating. And I know black guys, date out more than probably the black women, and black people seem to be the only race of people that will date other people instead of dating each other. Like Asian people will date Asian people, Hispanic people will date Hispanic people, Middle Eastern people will date each other, other races of people will date within their own race, but black people are the only people that be like, yeah, you should go outside and you should have mixed babies and you should talk to other people and blah blah. And I remember when I was in middle school, my mom told me and my brother to find white partners because black guys are trash and they're not, because black people are trash and they're not good enough and blah blah blah. And the funny thing is, when I was in high school, I used to have that mindset. I didn't want to end up with a black person. I actually wanted to end up with South Korean guy, And I think probably that because actually I discovered Korean music, Korean pop music from South Korea in high school, and I loved it. This has nothing to do with the video, but I haven't listened to like any new artists, any new South Korean artists, so I don't know. And every time I do listen to Korean music, it's always the old stuff. I like the old stuff better. But anyway, I would fantasize about being with a Korean guy, being with a Hispanic guy. I would fantasize about being with like all other types of men instead of with a black guy, And then something looks weird on my door. What was I talking about? Oh yeah, and then I went through this phase of liking white guys who like wore all black, the goth people. So I had that phase, and then something happened. Then I was like, ew, no, gross, I don't want no white person, So then I was like, oh my god, I want a black partner, And I remember I watched this video, and this woman was talking about how black women shouldn't be waiting until they meet a black guy. She was like, oh, you should give yourself a chance, and what if the person that you're supposed to be with is not black? What if he's a white guy or a Hispanic guy, whatever, Asian guy. I remember somebody wrote a comment under a video and they were like, no. They were like, well, I, you know, while there's nothing wrong with interracial dating and all this stuff, and yeah, if you find love with someone else who's not black, good for you. But she was like, but I am waiting. I will purposely, she said she was purposely waiting until she met a black guy. And I was like, and I read that comment and I thought to myself, me too. And, you know, if I had to wait until I was 45 to meet a black person, because I met somebody now, you know, if I was still single now, and if I had to wait until I was 45 to meet somebody, meet a black person, I would have waited until I was 45 to meet that person. You know, I know for me, like, I don't want to be with someone who's not black, because, like, even because we both had jobs and then we both lost our jobs. And his job, you know, when he first started there, like, there were a lot of black people. But then as the months went by, as weeks and months went by, it's like all the black people are gone. And at my job, when I started, when I used to go there in the morning time, I was the only black person. So my shift was in the morning, and I would leave, like, it was from 7 to 2 p.m., so I would leave at 2 p.m. So when I would leave, when I was leaving at 2 p.m., and when the people were coming in for the afternoon shift, you know, from 2 to 9 or whatever, that's when I would see all the black people. So I would be like, okay, so when I come in the morning, I'm the only black person, but when I leave, that's when the other black people will show up. You know, and it was annoying. I hated it. It was weird. And then there was one other Asian person, but it's like, okay. She was probably like, she wasn't black and Asian. So, you know, I can't relate to anybody, all of this stuff. You know, and then when my shift changed from the morning to the afternoon, kind of, then I started seeing more black people, and I was like, oh my god, are there black people in here? Oh my god, you know? And I was friendly with some of the other non-black people too, but it made me felt, I felt seen, because I was like, oh my god, I'm not the only black person at this job, at this place. Like, there's other black people here too, you know? And then when he would talk to me about stuff like that, it's like, I already understand. And when I would tell him stuff like that, he already understands, because it's happening to both of us. So it's like, if I was complaining to him about being the only black person at work, he could understand. If I was to tell someone, a white person, that, he would probably be like, yeah, you know, I know how it feels, but it's like, yeah, you can understand, but it's like, you can understand, but then you can't really understand, because that's never happened to you before. And then when I tell my boyfriend about stuff like that, I don't have to explain. All I have to say is, oh my god, man, I'm the only black person here, or whatever. And he will get it. To a non-black person, it's like, I have to explain to you why I even have a feeling, why I feel bad about that, or why I feel a type of way about that. I have to explain to you. And I don't want to be with someone where, if I am the only black person somewhere, or if I feel a certain type of way around a certain type of people, I should just be able to say, I feel like this, or I went here and I was the only person here. I shouldn't have to be like, well, you know, I was the only person here and I felt like this, and I felt like this because of this, this, this. Like, that's too much, and that's annoying. So I, as a black woman, I'm gonna tell other black women that, you know what, if you want, you know, if you don't want to date interracially, or if you don't want to do that, and if you want to end up with a black guy, if you want to meet, you know, you want to have a family with a black kid, if you want to have kids with a black man, if you want to spend the rest of your life with a black man, if you want to grow old and get married, I'm here to tell you, you know what, it's okay. It's okay if that's what you want, and if other people try to tell you different, fuck them, who cares, it's your life, you should do what you want, you should do what makes you happy, you know. And me and my partner, we really feel deep down inside that my mom's not happy that I'm with him, because he's not white, or because he's black, period, and he's Asian, because she told me not to bring home an Asian man. So that's besides the point, you know, but that's how we both feel. And it's kind of annoying, you know, because I'm sure other women, other daughters don't have to go through this, where they have to think about, you know, it's like I introduce my mom to my boyfriend, I shouldn't have this feeling of like, oh, she's probably jealous that I'm with him, or why, you know, she's probably not happy that I'm with him, or she feels that I could do better. Like, I shouldn't have that feeling. I should introduce her to him, and it should be like, oh my god, okay, cool, whatever. You know, it should be like a happy, joyful feeling, but it's not. But that's besides the point. You know, but I don't know, I'm here to say, like, you know, if you want to date a black guy, who cares? Who fucking cares? And yes, men suck and the majority of men are trash. But you know what? Not all of them are trash, and not all of them are shitty, and not all of them suck, and not all of them will treat you like complete garbage, and not all of them will treat you like something to just sleep with all the time and trash. You know, that's like saying all women are gold diggers. That's not true. You know, that's not true at all. Some women like money, some women don't really care. You know, that might be hard to believe, but you know, like, yeah, men do suck and the whatever, but not all the men in the entire fucking world, they're all not like that, and they will all not treat you like garbage, and they will all not treat you like trash and all this stuff. You know, some of them will actually like you for who you are and want to be with you because of the person that you are, you know, and because they find you attractive and because they like who you are inside here, you know. So yeah, so if you want to date a black guy, by all means do it. Who cares what other black women say? You know, every time I hear other black women say that, or every time I see a post, every time I see a black woman post about that, like, I don't comment, I comment in my head, because I'm not using my energy to comment on stuff that I don't really agree with or that I don't care about. But I laugh to myself and I'm like, not me, couldn't be me. That makes them happy, good for them. You know, if being with a non-black person makes you happy, good for you. Some black women are like, I'm done with black guys, fuck them, I'm never going back, that's not my problem. You know, different things make different people happy. So, but I know for me, I would not be happy if my partner wasn't black. So, and it works for me, and I'm happy, you know. So yeah, so it's not wrong to wait for your dream black guy. You know, some people meet them early in life, some people meet them later in life, like me. Even though I'm not old, I'm not an old person, I'm not middle age, you know, some people met their partners at 21, I had to wait, you know, until I was 26, even though 26, it's not old at all, you know, but I felt like I was waiting for a long time, so yeah, this video is getting too long, so that's basically what I wanted to say. You know, there's nothing wrong with waiting for your dream black man, there's nothing wrong with waiting for a black man, if that's what you want, it's okay. You know, why can't black people be like other races where we date each other, where we date inside a race instead of always going out and, you know, all of that stuff. But that's beyond me, so that's basically what I wanted to say. You know, I'm trying to be a lot more consistent on this channel. You know, I don't want to go like 5 months without making a video and stuff like that. But then the hard part is like actually coming up with topics. So yeah, I've been dying to make a video about something, but then I don't know if I should make it, because the video, like, I don't have kids, but the video, I can relate to it a lot, but I don't know if I should make it, because I feel like people are gonna have, like, negative responses to it, but I'm not sure. Maybe I'll just make it and see what happens, whatever, you know. I don't know. And if I don't like it, I can always take it down. So that's basically what I wanted to say. If you're a black woman and you're waiting for your black man, by all means, do it. You know, there's nothing wrong with it. You know, hey, I waited. You know, and I think with most people, I feel like the moment you stop thinking, well, I don't know if it's thinking, but I think the moment you become content with being with something, I think that's when you get what you want. It's like when you're wanting a boyfriend and you want somebody and you're looking for a relationship and you're looking for a partner, I think the moment you say to yourself, I'm content with being single, I'm content with being by myself, and if I meet somebody, it's okay, but if I don't meet somebody, it's also okay, and if I don't ever meet somebody, it will also be okay. I think that moment when we become content with how something is, that's when, whenever whatever we wanted in the first place will actually finally come to us. Because I feel like for me, the moment I became content and I really told myself, like, hey, you know what? I do want somebody. It would be nice being alone, being single. Yeah, it's okay. It would be better if I had somebody. But I'm okay. I'm not going to die. My world's not going to end. I'm not going to suffer from a heart attack. And I think the moment I really became content with that, because I was working towards that, I would always tell myself, like, oh, it's okay, it's okay. And the moment I was like, you know what? If I don't ever meet anybody, I'm okay. Like, my life is not going to be over. I am not going to. My life is not going to be worthless if I don't ever meet somebody. Like, it will be okay. I think the moment I said that to myself, and I actually wrote it down, because I wrote it down because I wanted it to be written down. I don't know, whatever. I don't know why I wrote it down. Maybe there's a reason. But I wrote it down, and I read it to myself, and I closed it, and I was like, that is it. This is it. It's okay. The moment I did that, I met my boyfriend. So, I don't know. I think that actually works. When we become content with things, that's when the things that we really want come into our lives. I don't know. You know, I feel like that's true. I don't know if that's true for other people, but I feel like for me, because I feel like if I kept complaining about how I'm not with anybody, because all the times when I was complaining, I had never met anybody, I didn't meet anybody, but the moment I was like, it's okay, here he came. So yeah, so that's basically what I wanted to say. So until next time. Bye.